Serious, Redditors from Lebanon or Beirut, how are you after the horrific explosion in the city? Lived a kilometer away from the explosion, I left Lebanon 2 weeks ago to visit family. My house is completely destroyed and unlivable. My two closest friends were my roommates, one was in the bathroom when it happened, the other was outside walking back from work. They were sending me voice notes of what was going on while it happened. These two men are the strongest people I know, and getting messages from both of telling me to tell their families they love them in case anything happens shakes you. If they were in their rooms, I can't begin to imagine what would have happened to them. They're both safe now in the mountains. Thankfully no one I know is dead, just lots of injuries. My brother felt the shockwave 12 to 14 miles east a lot later than I did. I was about 2 miles south, but I managed to reach home without major injuries. I wasn't scared from a trembling building and shattered windows, not cause I'm so great, but I didn't process what happened. Saw the mushroom cloud and genuinely thought we got nuked. I didn't understand the blast and what I went through before I saw all the videos online. I got extremely lucky. Edit, thanks everyone for the support. I'm fine and managed to sleep a bit. Prayers go out to all affected more than me. My apartment is 2 kilometers away from Beirut port. I'm fine. Just lots of broken windows. No one was injured near me. Mom was shocked. I don't know what will happen next. 2019, we lost all our money. 2020, COVID-19, daily 20 hours power cuts. Let me tell you that I could still feel the burden of the shockwave for more than 15 minutes afterward. I have felt the shockwave from a C4 explosion, and it felt like an ice cold wind that rushed through my body and left me tingling and quite upset for a while. It was quite phenomenal. Well, in my case, I'm fine. I took all the earthquake procedures my family practices once a month in case of an earthquake, then left the building as soon as the shaking stopped. Then came the horrifying part, the smoke, and then boom, the shockwave. I was deafened for about 30 seconds and got a few minor scratches on my arm, but other than that I'm fine. Can't speak for at least 4.5k others though, sadly. Shocked, heartbroken, and hopeless. Ears still ringing from the blast. Friends and family injured. I don't know how Lebanon is going to cope with this drama and move on. The whole explosion was like an out-of-body experience that keeps playing over and over in my head. My grandmom sadly passed away, while my brother came out safely with a few burns. My dad was on a call with someone he works with in Beirut. The call went 5 minutes late, so the guy stayed in his room. Then everything blew up. His apartment got cut in half, with only his room not being 100% obliterated. But he was able to survive because he was in his room. He would have gone into his living room, which got completely blown up. But he hadn't, because if the call hadn't gone late, he would have died. But his apartment is gone. Truly shows how many people barely escape these situations with random things like a work call going late. Because of the rising COVID-19 cases the past week, I asked my company yesterday if I could work from home for the meantime to keep my family safe, and they agreed. The explosion happened at around 18:05, at which time I would still be in the office. My workplace building collapsed from the inside, and people rushed out while the building was falling on top of them. I can't shake off the feeling that I pretty much just escaped death, and it is surreal. My aunt's house got destroyed, and I had to go pick her up. There was shattered glass everywhere, dust, and debris. But the shit that gets you is how silent and loud, if that makes any sense? Being in the middle of it actually is. All you hear are sirens, echoing alarms, and screams of people looking for each other. I am outraged because of this government and its incompetence. Not once did it manage to do anything good for the country. I wanted to go down and hang all of them on the streets, including their puppet master Hassan Nasrallah. Edit, just so you know, when the explosion happened, everyone around the world was making statements and giving their condolences, even Israel. Our president? Nothing. Not even 14 hours after the explosion. Please do not give me awards. If you're feeling generous, donate instead to the Lebanese Red Cross. Thank you. Lebanese American here. I am currently in the US, but I have lots of friends and family there. In fact, one of my friends lives directly in front of where the explosion happened, and my aunt is a couple more blocks away. Luckily, no one I know has lost their life due to the catastrophe, but several were injured, some badly. Others have lost their homes, as the damage is extensive. People all over the country are opening their homes to all those who lost their homes. Others are planning to go down to Beirut and help with the cleanup. The government is so corrupt and are completely incapable of handling this. For the last 30 years we have had warlords and criminals in power. They line their pockets with government funds and from kickbacks from contacts that they award without a bidding process. This could have been prevented, but as usual, the government did nothing but store 2,700 tons of ammonium nitrate in a densely populated area. I think people are going to use their anger and outrage to remove every last member of the government and hold them accountable for their corruption and neglect. I'm okay, I guess. I literally keep replaying the explosion in my head. I keep replaying every single motion and movement I did. I hear my mom's scream echo in my head. And then mine. In a weird fucked up replay that I can't press the stop button. But I'm adjusting. I finally stopped crying, which is a step forward. But I'm still scared of any and all noises. I have family in Lebanon. There was a church service going on, and whilst the priest was sensing the church, all the windows shattered and the ceiling caved in. Also, my cousin lived in Beirut and was renting a house. He moved 1 week ago back to his summer home, and his former house is now most likely destroyed, since his neighbor's homes are in near rubble. I'm an expat here, living nearby it. A bit shook up. I thought my partner and I were going to die. We hid under the bed. I thought it was the predicted once in a century 8.0 earthquake. Then I thought terrorists or Israeli strike as we fled into the street to open ground. I am extremely glad it was not those things. Those things would be worse. Goddamn, I was happy to get drunk last night. My fiancé is from Lebanon. Born and raised came here about 10 years ago. He said no one will know the real truth for quite a while. The government there is so corrupt they will hide it and they never tell the truth. With the losses caused in the capital, it will be a huge hit on the economy that is already dying. Please like and subscribe, and tap the notification bell icon below to get notified of more Reddit DTS videos. This is RedditJoe channel. Your everyday Reddit.